Mahi-Mahi, Dorado, Dodo. The common dolphinfish has a lot of names. No matter what you call it, one thing's for sure. This is a spectacular game fish, one that excites anglers all around the world. One thing that's not for sure, though, is which works better when you're trying to catch these fish, bait or lures. We're about to find out.
Today on Got Bait, it's all kinds of plastic lures versus yummy squid and fish chunks.
Squid. Squid.
We're going offshore today for mahi-mahi. The boys insisted on being team bait. That leaves me with lures, but I think I can beat them with my secret weapon. I tied this tandem rig with a big lure and a little lure, so it looks like a big fish is chasing a little fish. It should really get those mahi charged up. My special guest fisherman today is Captain Larry Golden. I wanted him to be on my team, Team Lures, because let me tell you, this guy lives and breathes fishing. And he's got a bigger boat than me.
The Got Bait crew will be searching for dolphin fish in an area known as Poor Man's Canyon at the very edge of the continental shelf, about 60 miles off the Delmarva coast. Out here in the middle of nowhere, the mahi-mahi often gather under lobster trap floats. The Got Bait crew is tagging and releasing dolphinfish in cooperation with the Dolphinfish Research Program, performed by Cooperative Science Services. The goal of the program is to better understand the migration patterns of dolphinfish in the open Atlantic.
One of the mahi that we tagged a few years back was actually recaptured the very next day. It had traveled 6.8 miles. Now that might sound like a lot, but actually in this tagging program, it was proven that one fish traveled 130 miles in 24 hours.
Each team will earn 1 point per inch for every mahi they catch. And since tagging takes time, tagged fish get 5 bonus points.
Each time we pull up next to a float, we'll throw a handful of juicy squid chunks and fish chunks into the water to get the mahi-mahi very excited. That means cutting up a lot of chunks. It's a messy job, but I love it.
I am so glad that Max cut up all the bait. Ew.
Man, I'm really glad Max cut up all the bait.
Ever since Max took over the job, I kind of miss hacking up all the fish and squid.
Ah, I cut my finger. I need some bandages.
What happened?
Just kidding.
Are you trying to give me a heart attack?
Cruising at about 25 knots, it'll take the guys over 2 hours to reach these mahi-rich waters. That means there's time to catch up on some sleep. Favorite activity for certain anglers.
Wake up, guys, and get ready. The first float of the day is on the horizon. Come on, mahi. All right, guys, today we're keeping score on this board right here. Don't forget, measure every fish you catch and then write down how many inches it is up here. No measurement, no credit. Now, even though the boys have done a whole lot of boat washing lately, they're still willing to make the same bet. The losing team washes down the boat while the winning team gets to kick back and watch.
We are not gonna have to wash down the boat today.
Uh-uh, no way.
The rigs we're using are super simple. A 30-pound fluorocarbon leader tied off to a 6-aught circle hook. You can either use a fish chunk or squid. Make sure to cover the hook as much as possible.
The 20-pound spinning gear that we're using just can't handle a monster bull dolphin. So that's why we always carry around this lunker rod, which has 60-pound test on it. If we spot a giant, we'll put a whole fish on our hook and try to get that big boy on the end of our line. Notice the circle hooks? We're using circle hooks for a very specific reason. See if you can guess what it is. A, because J hooks lead to more missed bites. B, because it's easier to hide circle hook in a bait. Or C, because circle hooks help prevent leader chase.
To find out the answer, and find out whether bait or lures will prove to be the winner when it comes to dolphin fish, stick around for the next segment of Got Bait.